yung issue niya, yung goal niya, nasira. That's why, kung patingin niyo sa yun, and sometimes, sobrang, so, sa ibang stages ng relationship natin kay God, paminsan-minsan, medyo influential yung third thing. Kasi hindi natin alam na things within our fight, hindi na pala. Nag-win na pala siya. At hindi yung thing, nasisira na pala yung relationship natin. And that's why, kumaan nyo sa Luke 11, verse 9, sabi ko nga, and I say unto you, ask, and it shall be given. Ask, and it shall be given. Seek, and you shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened to you. Question there, lahat naman tayo, we seek what is right. The problem is, how are we going to seek? How are we going to seek? How are we going to seek the right relationship with God? Kasi sa akala natin, which ako, it's tilted about dati. Akala mo lang dati, a simple prayer, a simple pagbabasa, ano kay through time, pagbabasa, it will help me pull up or catch up sa mga pagkukulang ko sa relationship, sa relationship ko sa Diyos sa kanila. But then, kung titingnan mo yung the manner of seeking na kailangan, pati pala natin mag-check, makuha yun sa Proverbs. So, sa Proverbs chapter 2, verses 3 to 5. Which said doon, yea, if thou criest after knowledge, and liftest up thy voice for understanding, if thou seekest her as silver, and searchest for her as for hid treasures, thou shalt, then shalt thou understand the fear of God, and find the knowledge. The fear of the Lord, and find the knowledge of God. So, hindi lang siya simple-simple allocate ko lang ng time. Kailangan, it has to be in you the desire to seek, the desire to know. And then, once you reach that state, yung desire mo to para malaman, then yun papat yung seek and you shall find. Not only will you find what you're seeking, pero merong additional yung wisdom, yung knowledge na ibibigay sa iyo. Now, as you seek, you will find out what is true, what is hidden, and hindi natin namalayan yung kakananong third will. What is will be self? So, once you have seeked, and once you understand the fear of the Lord, and once you find the knowledge of God, you'll be able to find what is your real relationship. Okay. And like all relationships, because God is love.
Amen. Amen.
And then you communicate to God, that's a relationship. That is love. The communication you get to Him. It can also be understood as a love letter. Like my old school. It's always love letters. The love letter we get from God, para sa atin, para communicate sa kanila. It's not a normal love letter that we see all around.
Right.
The love letter that we get from God, it's the perfect love letter.
Amen.
The Bible.
Amen.
So perfect that it has been considered as the best-selling book. Wala kang nakatalo. That's how perfect the love letter is. Okay? Like other love letters, Sinseta is perfect. When you read it and it communicates to you, doon nakikita mo ang usong sabihin niya. Ang usong sabihin niya. Like the love letter, yun naman kita mo yung courtship. Paano ka nilinawan ni Diyos? Paano ka nilinawan yun? Included in that courtship, maipapaintindi sa iyo, Diyos, what happened, like other relationships, my ex. There's always an ex. Sorry. It has been, whenever may bagong relationship, bago parating pa lang doon, ipaparang dapat. Isa sa mga tinatang ko, if meron siya. Okay, so don't really get kung gano'ng katindi yung past. Usually, ang sagot is yes. Now, ang next tanong ko, what went wrong? What went wrong sa relationship sa past? Ano doon? Normal relationship, pag-i-went. Now, same with the fact, the reason ko ba nagtatanong ako is because once malaman mo yung reason, bakit nag-fail yung previous relationship is yun yung iiwasan mo. Iiwasan mo siya para hindi magyari sa'yo na ikaw yung may mali. So, same with the love letter. Sometimes, sabi na, the Old and the New Testament, the New Testament is there kasi yung the Old has been fulfilled. But if you're going to check also, on the Old Testament, you will see yung X. Yung X, which is, we know, Israel. What went wrong with Israel? Because we all know na it's because of Israel's shortcoming kaya ang biyaya na punta sa atin sa mga Gentiles. Since napunta na sa atin, which was not meant for us, then we have to cherish it. Hindi natin kailangan na i-treat siya as doon nakasulat sa New Testament. Parang sobrang yung the opportunity is there na kailangan natin i-treasure. Hindi natin siya kailangan i-treat na parang perlas na nahalis sa mga bago. Instead, we will treat it as an opportunity na like yung crumbs na for the child na sa table dapat tapos nalaglag sa table, tinahin ang ato. That's how we're going to cherish that opportunity.
Amen.
Para hindi mawala.
Amen.
Para hindi mawala. And also, like any love letters, may proposal. May proposal din yung Diyos yung Panginoon sa atin. Mababasa natin. But the proposal is there na if we follow, if we abide, alam natin, since we know what the proposal is, the focusing natin, ano pwede natin ma-reward kung makamtan natin at the end. Which, that's the reason kung bakit kahit na, hindi siya ganun ka-convenient sa atin to sacrifice time. Hindi siya ganun kadali sa atin na mag-iba tayo yung dapat gawin. Pero we need to set it aside.
Amen.
Kasi we know there is something special. Something special na kailangan natin bigyan ng panahon. Bigyan ng dedication. Because we know what lies beyond. Hindi man natin makita right now. We don't know when it will come, but we know it will come.
Amen.
Yun yung nilolong natin.
Amen.
Like a love letter, perfect love letter, comes to the proposal then it has guidelines. Guidelines not only ilang guidelines kwento sa X na something went wrong, which is the L, pero we know that there's guidelines na what we need to do para hindi tayo magulat. So, since the one that we have now, in the grace of God, the Lord Jesus Christ, is a new covenant. We were now for that new covenant, how are we going to walk along on that new covenant para patuloy tayo sa right path towards the kingdom of God in His righteousness. So in it is included in guidance sa new covenant. Okay? And the new guidance is like love letter, mayroon din siyang part ng since the proposal, the engagement of which I know it has been shared past few weeks na on the stages of our relationship with God, Jesus Christ, there is already an engagement. Mayroon ng marriage between us na nananampalataya sa ating Panginoon. That's why and that engagement tapos pagdating sa that marriage which is what do you call it, which is sealed by the baptism wherein we have done our part. That's our, you know, part natin to baptism to seal that marriage. Okay, kasi you can see as I was reading that in John chapter 3 verse 3, Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. And tayo mga pananampalataya, we know that this requirement from Jesus Christ, we know what it means. It means being baptized. Being baptized, and by that, you are born again. Baptized in the Spirit.
Amen.
Now, regarding baptism, the question lies first. Is baptizing in the name of the Father and of the Son and Holy Ghost or Holy Spirit, is it sufficient? Others, sa ibang mga denomination, they think it's sufficient. Pero sa ating mga pataya, na narinig sa akin kung ano yung tama, we know that beyond it, there is the name. The name, kung kanino tayo dapat mabaptize.
Amen.
Now, Let me answer. Next is my question regarding baptism. Is baptizing the name of the Lord Jesus Christ sufficient? Before I go to the question, isa to sa pinag-pray ko din, saan hindi ako magkakali. So, kung magkakali ako, I'm open for question. Now, we know that we need to be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Kasi alam natin, there's only one name. We let them say, under that name,
right,
which is no other name is above it.
Yes.
From heaven and earth. Not no name is above it. So, back to my question. If we look at my question per se, as it is, na it's baptizing the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, like, I can answer yes. As it is, baptizing in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, which is the name is insufficient. Okay? But like the third wheel, by going the third wheel, since relationship ang nag-team, the enemy, or you see the third wheel, Satan, recognize it earlier, is very desperate. He will do everything from the smallest thing to whatever is complex or to whatever is very, very, very obvious. Gagamitin na yun just to ruin the relationship we have with the Lord Jesus Christ, with God. Now, so, if we easily walk, baptizing the name of the Lord Jesus Christ sufficient, now comes the answer. Sabi niya, correct me if I know, I'm not pero if you will hear me out, the reason why I say no is not sufficient. It's because, like what I said, the third wheel, grabe siya ka-desperate na kanit na bagay. Kung pwede niya magamit yan just to ruin our relationship, he will do it. And to prove it, tulad daw nangyari sa time sa Garden of Eden. It's just one word. Nagayin lang siya na una. Only at one word. Ganun siya ka-desperado. Ganun siya ka-paning. Ganun siya ka-daling pangdaya. And what I understand, the third wheel, the enemy is ancient. So speaking of experience, sobra-sobra na yung experience niya. Super dad. So back to my answer, why do, ang sagot is no, is because, kaya nga sulat, 2 in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 15. And that he died for all. We know this is our Lord Jesus Christ. That they which live not henceforth live from still unto themselves, but unto him which died for them in the cross again. Okay? So and we have to understand that we have such a Ephesians chapter 4, verse 5, there's only one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. So, kung babalik tayo sa unang requirement, yung sabi ni Isla, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, you cannot enter the kingdom of God, the baptism should be perfect. In the same way that we want to have a perfect relationship with our God. Okay? Now, the reason is our Corinthians chapter 5. Second Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, which says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. We got that after baptism. That's why we are married for our Lord Jesus Christ. We are married now. And he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become a new creature. Now, if you look at the Deuteronomy, which verse 15 and 17, okay, it talks more about what happens after baptism. Now, if we are baptized in Christ, we are expected na, because
when we are baptized, our sin is nailed with him during that time. When we rise on that baptism, in the same way we rise with Jesus Christ who has been resurrected, we are anew. Now, the reason why sinabi ko no, that it's not sufficient, it's because Satan is using this one. Satan is using, ang una ginamit na ni Satan yung baptizing in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, ginamit na niya yun to ruin a perfect relationship. Kasi once there is a flaw, then it is not perfect. Okay? So if the baptism is not, if there's a flaw in the baptism, then the relationship is not perfect. Same sa baptizing in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Sige, you were baptized in that name. Okay? But when you rise, how did you rise? Comes the question, how did you rise? Did you rise in accordance with the one who sacrificed himself to save you? Or did you rise in accordance to the doctrine of the church, the doctrine of the church that baptized you? If it is in the doctrine of the church that baptized you, my next question, is that doctrine the doctrine of Christ? Or is it a doctrine that has been adulterated? If it has been adulterated, then there is something, there is a flaw in the process of that baptism. So if there's a flaw in the process of that baptism, how will you know na, diba, three, the third is baptism of the Holy Ghost? Yun. How do you know that naabot mo yung the third one, which is baptism of the Holy Ghost? When it's possible na since that church is having its own doctrine, it's possible that the Holy Spirit which reside in that church has been grieved. When it has been grieved, it departs. When it departs, it's not there. And when it's not there, hindi mo masasabi na nakuha mo yung baptize, yung baptism by the Holy Ghost, because it's not there. And listen, the intentions that each Christian, each person has para makuha yung perfect relationship is there, it's genuine. But, kailangan, we have to be sure, we have to be vigilant enough na hindi tayo madaya. Remember, like what I said, the third wheel is very cunning. Lahat na maliliit na maliliit na pwede, dadamitin ngayon. Now, so tulad ng example, if it's on a doctrine which is not a doctrine of not the doctrine of Christ, hindi naman basta-basta mapapansin din yun. Kasi ganun ka galing mandaya yung third wheel, yung the God of this evil world. Ipapakita niya what is partly true, what is hidden, and what is misrepresented. So, that's why yung titingnan natin, mahilam sa New Testament, there has been a group that has been baptized again. When they had a conversation with St. Paul, na when they were asked, under whose name were they baptized? Yung sinagot nila is, they were baptized by the, baptized by John. The repentance of John. And because of that, since the baptism that they had was not perfect, they were baptized again. They were re-baptized. So, it doesn't, I'm not saying, brothers and sisters, sana huwag niyo akong ma-misquote na yung baptizing in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ is not sufficient. I hope you understand kung saan ako nanggaling, why it is not sufficient. Pero, if the baptism that we have, of which when we rise, is we rise in accordance with the Lord Jesus Christ, then we have the right baptism. And if it's not, then it's very reasonable enough na tulad nung nasa yung nakausap ni St. Paul, nagpa-rebaptize sila. Para lang makuha yung the proper and the perfect baptism. In order to keep that relationship, because when because sa baptism na yan, ang completion of that baptism comes the marriage, the relationship that we have with our Lord Jesus Christ. Okay? Now, speaking of the relationship and that marriage, okay, a sample of how the relationship that we're supposed to have with our Lord Jesus Christ, it can be, pwede natin siya i-pattern sa relationship ng couple, Christian couple, which is nakikita natin sa 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 5. It says there, it's written as, "For after this matter, in the old time, the holy women also, who trusted in God, adorned themselves, being in subjection unto their husbands." Now, getting this as the pattern, knowing that sa baptism, after baptism, we are part of the church, which is the wife of the of our Lord Jesus Christ. Christ is the head, he's the husband. Which means each of us should be subject to our Lord Jesus Christ. That being said, the doctrines that we should follow should be the doctrine that is coming from Christ.
Amen.
Okay? Okay? Now, based on like a normal marriage, okay, normal relationship marriage that we have, like dito sa mundong to, yung temporal, okay, the marriage is tested. Sometimes it's always tested. Not tested from within. It can also be tested from an external force. That's why, kung makikita nyo sa 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 14, it was written, "If you be reproached for the name of Christ, happy are ye, for the Spirit of glory and of God resteth upon you, and on their part he is evil spoken of, but on your part he is glorified." So that being said, alam natin, usually pag may makita, magko-comment, "Ay, ganyan ba yung born again? Ganyan ba yung Christian?" Ganyan. O paminsan-minsan, knowing who we are, Christians or born again Christians, or Mrs. Jesus Christ, sometimes yung iba mag-aabang na lang ng mali. Just to show their disappointment sa atin. Just to show their disapproval sa atin. Of which, we know na kung hindi nila alam na born again Christian tayo, kung hindi nila alam na Mrs. Jesus Christ tayo, they will not show us that kind of disappointment, or they will not express that kind of disapproval sa atin. Okay? Now, having Jesus Christ as our husband, of which we have to be obedient and be subject to him, as he said it in John chapter 14 verse 6, Jesus said unto him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me." Now, with this, that is why, okay, this being written, this being communicated to us, that is why we, as the wife of our Lord Jesus Christ, okay, keeping the relationship that we have with God, yung dual relationship lang na hindi makapangdaya yung third way, okay, we should always look unto Jesus, which you can see in Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2. We should always look unto Jesus as the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising shame, and he sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. If you're going to see, what? That's why our Lord Jesus Christ, okay, he had that joy of such sacrifice. He humbled himself from having the same form with God. He humbled himself. He take the cross and the shame on that cross. Okay, like sa ibang doctrine, nakita mo sa way of the cross, there is total shame. There is no honor in it. But the joy that he had, the reason why he pursued it and he see the joy, because nakita niya at the end, masisave niya yung wife. Like any husband will do. Kahit eto, human husband. Husbands will always protect their wives. Amen. Eh, eto pa, si Jesus Christ, which is, in Him is God. He did everything. Sacrifice to the utmost just to make sure that at the end we can be saved. That at the end we will be able, we can be presented to the Father as the wife. Okay? And because of that, that's why, since Jesus Christ is our brother, Jesus Christ is our husband. Okay? That's why we have him, and then since on the far end, he's the one who's going to present us to the Father. That's why even from now, he's protecting his wife so much that he is standing as the mediator. He's standing as the mediator of the new covenant, which is of the sprinkling of his blood. And you can have it reference on Hebrews chapter 12, verse 24. Okay? As well in Hebrews 8, chapter 8, verse 13, he said, a new covenant he had made, the first old. Now that which decayeth and waxed old is ready to vanish away. And because of that, dwelling simulat sa Colossians chapter 2, verses 16 to 17. Because we are under a new covenant, I said that, let no man therefore judge you in meat, or in drink, or in respect of an holiday, or of the new moon, or of the Sabbath days, which are a shadow of things to come, but the bodies of Christ, because it's the fulfillment. Okay. For the law, okay. For the law, having a shadow of good things to come, and not the very image of those things. So because of that, we should not. Okay. That being revealed to us already. Okay. Sometimes we can have this question: why is it still important for others? Or sometimes sa atin, pag medyo nahukpa tayo sa law, to chain themselves, or sometimes we can even include ourselves, chain themselves to the law, where in fact, the grace of God through the Lord Jesus Christ is right before us, within our grasp. Okay? The question goes there, is it because of defiance, or it's just merely unacceptance? Unacceptance, when I say unacceptance, unable to fully accept the new covenant. Maybe it's the reason. Okay? Now, we have to understand, brothers and sisters, na defiance or unacceptance to the word being shared, it leads to death.
That's right.
It leads to death. Okay? Tulad ng nakasulat, In 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 21, for it had been better for them not to have known the way of righteousness than after they have known it to turn from the holy commandment delivered unto them. That's how grave it is to turn your back on the revelation that has been shared. Galing siya importante. To give an example about death, or to give an example on defiance or unacceptance to the word being shared leads to death. An example dun is in 1 Kings chapter 13. The story is, the event is about dun sa man of God, Jeroboam, and the old prophet. To give a preview lang of that event, on verse 9 of 1 Kings chapter 13, okay, man of God said, for so it charged me by the word of the Lord, saying, eat no bread, nor drink water, nor turn again by the same way that thou camest. Which, pag tingnan mo yung event na yun, the man of God, on the first part of that event, sumunod siya. Kasi, he was supposed to be given a reward from Jeroboam, pero hindi niya tinanggap because inutusan na siya ng Panginoon na he's not supposed to go back, kailangan tuloy-tuloy lang yung pace niya or yung journey niya, tuloy-tuloy, hindi siya dapat babalik. But even though if dinecline na yung reward ng king, he still met his death. He met his death because the old prophet, kasi yung sinabi ko sa'yo, there was man of God, Jeroboam, an old prophet. The old prophet tricked him. Okay? The old prophet tricked him saying na he was told, he was told by an angel na dapat bumalik kumain. At magstay pa yata. Kumain. So, since the man of God hearing the word na angel, he was told by that the old prophet was informed or told by the angel na the man of God needs to go back, he went back. And because of that, when he went back, he disobeyed. Because he disobeyed, when he left, like death, like what I said earlier na defiance or unacceptance of the word being shared leads to death, nung sumakay siya sa ass, parang donkey po yata yun, same like a donkey, pagsakay niya sa donkey, sa ass or donkey, pagabante, the lion was there. The lion, what the lion did is, siya lang yung pinatay. Kinain mo siya pa siya? Pinatay na yata. Siya lang. And yung ass or yung donkey, hindi ginalaw. When persons, yung mga taong dumaan, they saw the carcass, the dead, the ass or yung donkey, and the lion. Which proves na it is extraordinary na hahayaan lang ng lion yung donkey sa tabi niya na hindi niya kakainin din, na hindi niya patayin. Which only proves that the death came, the death was a punishment, punishment for him. It's a punishment for him from God kasi hindi siya sumunod. Now, sige, his intention is clear. His conscience is clear. Kasi ang sabi, the angel told me. Yung sabi ng old prophet eh, the angel told me. But, like what I've said, sa love letter, it shows us what happened in the past. Kasi kung titingin mo sa New Testament, it was also been written by St. Paul sa Galatians chapter 1, verses 8 to 9. Sabi doon, but though we or an angel from heaven preach another gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. As we said before, so say I now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you than that you have received, let him be accursed. Okay? Now, how will we know? Now, how will we... Kasi alam natin, the third will is desperate. Ito yung na-share kanina. He will use anything. Mag-misrepresent siya. Yung lie niya, hindi small-time lie. A lie, yung lie niya is so convincing na madadaya ka. How will we know? The only way for us to know, love letter. We read the love letter again. As I read the love letter, we need to seek the truth in reading it. Now, time will come na kahit na mag-pray tayo before reading the Bible. Okay, or what I say now is in the love letter. It's possible na yung mababasa mo is you cannot understand. When you cannot understand it, dahil nag-pray, kahit nag-pray ka, hindi mo maintindihan. It doesn't mean that your prayer is unheard. It means also one thing, na as part ng guidance, it says mag-gather at magsipag-aralan. Which means, the revelation doesn't have to be coming from us all the time. Yung revelation, pwede mo makuha sa kapatiran, one of the brothers can even come. It doesn't have to come from the pastor. Sometimes it will go to the pastor. Sometimes, sa mga sisters, mga galing yung revelation. It is necessary because it will keep us humble. By that, hindi tayo magmamataas. Hindi tayo magmamataas na there's only one source. There's only one source. Because if it is so, ang dali na na matarget ng third wheel yung church, titirahin lang niya yung source, imi-mislead lang niya yung source, iko-corrupt lang niya yung heart mo source. That's right. And now, speaking of the third wheel, tulad sinabi ko, the third wheel is very cunning, very desperate na sirain ang relationship with God or relationship with Jesus Christ. And part of it is naging successful siya sa yung sa attempts niya, naging successful din siya. Doon sa temptation kay Jesus Christ, he failed. Because for sure, he doesn't stand a chance. Pero, with the circle na malapit kay Jesus Christ, even those na nasa yung 12 apostles, some of them, Satan was even able to go into them. For sure, one of the very obvious na Satan was able to go to one of the apostles was Judas. Satan went into Judas, and because of that, Judas betrayed Jesus Christ. Aside from that, Satan also went on Peter. That's why on two occasions, Peter failed. When Peter failed, sa Mark chapter 8, verse 33. Okay? When Jesus, when he turned about and looked on his disciples, and then he rebuked Peter, but he didn't address Peter as Peter, but instead he addressed get behind me, Satan. Amen. Si Peter yung andon. Pero why did Jesus Christ address it as Satan? Because Jesus Christ knows that Satan was able to go into him. In the same way, Peter failed dun sa he denied Jesus Christ 3 times. Satan was also able to go into him. Now, if you're going to check, if you're going to compare the two, parehas lang. They failed. Though Judas, on the end, killed himself. While Peter, on the end, he was given a chance to redeem himself. That's why, sinabihan siya ni Jesus Christ, feed my sheep, yung tinanong siya. Yeah. So which means, kahit malaki yung pagkakamali natin, even though if may times na Satan can come into us and sometimes rule over us, there is still this chance for us to redeem ourselves and to prove ourselves worthy to Jesus Christ, worthy to God, and worthy to keep that relation. Okay? Now, ito haba pala. Sorry, napahaba. Now, next thing, I'll just discuss three more things. Next thing that Satan will use as an element to ruin the relationship is the concept of a make-believer. That concept is very tricky. Kasi, concept of make-believer, usually a make-believer doesn't totally believe. He doesn't really believe. He pretends to believe. And by pretending to believe, akala niya okay na. And by that, dun nag-win over si Satan. Okay? So, having Jesus Christ as our husband, anyway, just to cut this short, I need to cut this short. Having Jesus Christ as our husband in spirit, okay, and we, by the church, the wife, comes question that being a faithful wife means loving the husband, loving Jesus Christ. The word love, okay, just tell me, the word love is not only a word spoken. Okay. A word love needs to be proved. Okay, it needs to be proven. Now, by that, as to how can we prove it? Okay, how can we prove that the love truly exists within us and our relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ? It exists by this. We can read it in John chapter 14, verse 21. He that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me, and he that loveth me shall be loved by my Father, and I will love him, and will manifest myself to him. Yes. And so this way. So if we love Jesus Christ, we should keep his commandments.
Amen.
Okay? And all things. And since now we know about how to prove love, okay? It's like this. And now that we know that all things, okay, will work together to them that love God. And because we love God, okay? And we are proving it that we love God by keeping His commandments. All things will together for good to be done for us. And this includes enduring until the end. Until the end is yun yung hinihintay natin. Until the end that we are saved, as it is written in Matthew 24:13. But he that shall endure until the end, and the same shall be saved.
Amen.
And when we say saved by God through the Lord Jesus Christ, It is saved in the very sense that at its, as it is written in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 52. Saved to that point wherein, in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall raise incorruptible, and we shall be changed.
Amen.
That is the saved part that we are looking for, that we are waiting for. So brothers and sisters, thank you. And tulad sinabi kanina, I'm open for correction. Kung meron man akong nasabing mali, or kung meron man akong nasaktan, apologies. So, tayo na pa tayo. Thank you.
Yes. Good.